The Philippines' education system is facing stumbling blocks, with students still lagging in terms of reading comprehension and mathematics. Edukasyon PH is helping bridge learning gaps and help students shape their own paths. Now, for more on this, we are joined by Deirdre Conde, COO of Edukasyon PH. Deirdre, thank you so much for joining us.
Happy to be here. Hi, Denise.
Now, we had Grace a couple of months back, you know, to talk about this initiative, but now it's really great that we have you to talk more about Edukasyon PH and what it does. And we've read that, you know, it really has had a significant impact on education in the Philippines. I mean, but as we close the year, can you share a specific success or story or notable achievements for this year that you believe really showcase the platform's influence?
Definitely. So thank you again for having us. One of the key successes that we have this year is actually one of the biggest gaps we've seen is really from education to employment. And definitely everyone's doing their part to make sure that we are updating the curriculum that we have in the schools to make sure that whatever we're teaching in the classrooms is really what's needed in the workforce right now. But of course, we need faster solutions as well. So one thing we're very proud of this year is actually through our partnership with AWS, we were able to do several cohorts of the AWS Restart program, where within 12 weeks, we're able to take those who are unemployed, underemployed, teach them cloud skills, and actually support them up until they get a job right after the 12-week program. So that's one of the key successes that we've had, bridging definitely education directly to employment. So that's something we're very proud of this year in Edukasyon, and we're actually hoping to get a bigger number of AWS Restart graduates for next year.
For those who are unfamiliar with AWS, what does that stand for, Deirdre?
Oh, sorry. So AWS is actually Amazon Web Services. Most of the technologies that we have to this day are on the cloud, and that's one of the platforms where it's housed.
And
so definitely a lot of companies, if they're actually looking...
Go ahead, Deirdre.
Yeah, a lot of companies here in the Philippines are actually looking to hire talent with cloud skills, but unfortunately, it's not something that we have readily available in the curriculum that we have. So through that 12-week boot camp, we're able to bridge that gap in a short span of time.
And Edukasyon PH, aside from AWS, you've also formed other partnerships, including one with Ayala Foundation. How have these collaborations enhanced the platform's ability to support students, especially those entering senior high school?
Definitely. So the one that you mentioned is actually with Ayala Foundation, very specifically making sure that more people know about some of the scholarships that are available. So we do have a scholarships platform on Edukasyon alongside our school's directory. So that's increasing also access to education, even if you don't have the financial means to cover for your tuition. So that's what the platform also does, making sure that these opportunities are easily accessible for a lot of our Filipino learners.
And now I've just read that the platform offers scholarships for students with athletic talent. How did you find integrating sports into education positively affected not just the students, but also the platform's goals?
Yeah, for sure. So ever since the pandemic, we've actually started introducing more topics that are important as well that are not in the classroom. So aside from, of course, your English, science, and math, those that are very structured, we also believe that extracurricular activities play a huge part in the education of our Filipino learners. So aside from sports, we also cover topics that we feel are very important for empowered Filipino youth, like civic education, financial literacy, climate action, hygiene. We've partnered with several like companies and NGOs to make sure that these topics are also knowledge that we're sharing with our Filipino learners for free.
And Edukasyon PH, you know, you offer a lot of things, scholarships, all of these training, but also the EDGE Tutor Program, of course. You know, how has this address the evolving needs of K-12 students, and what outcomes have you observed?
Yes, definitely. So this year alone, we've helped train some teachers, actually. What we've realized is to be able to make the biggest impact for our Filipino learners, it's more sustainable if we start with teachers. So we've been offering teacher training programs, especially for public high school teachers, for public school teachers from K to 12, to make sure that our teachers are equipped in supporting the students to address any like learning gaps in math and science, math and English. So that's a key focus that we have, teacher training. But aside from that, we've also been doing high dosage tutoring, but the bigger impact is really equipping our teachers.
And with the rise of online education because of the pandemic, what unique challenges and opportunities do you see and have you encountered in delivering these effective tutoring services? I mean, it's already quite complicated and challenging to have it in person way before this. How much more with, you know, online?
Definitely, it's been a challenge online. I think one of the key success drivers of the evolution of edutech in the future will be our internet infrastructure in the country. So that's definitely something we're hoping we can all work together to improve for access to internet. Because definitely faster internet means faster access to all of these different tools. So that's one infrastructure. But the other thing is there's really a crucial role for the parent. Of course, definitely, especially when we're dealing with younger children, we don't want them to access the internet on their own. So that means their main support in accessing these services online is really through their parents. So there's also very important focus on making sure that the parents are also digitally literate so that they can support their kids in accessing these tools that will be very helpful for them.
And let's talk about your modules, because they offer career guidance and, you know, of course, easing into society. And those really are the key features of Edukasyon.ph. How did you find these components contributing to a holistic learning experience for students? And what societal issues do you aim to address through them?
Definitely. So one of our key beliefs in Edukasyon is really like learning also happens outside of the classroom. And the goals of education is really not just so that you can get a job after, but you live a happy, successful life and you're contributing to society. So one of the things we've taken a look at is like, what does an empowered Filipino look like? That's really where we are rooted in. And so from there, that's where we figured out like some of the topics like financial literacy, civic education, climate action education is very important for students to learn about even outside of the classroom, so that they're empowered to think of solutions that can help overall our society and our community.
And speaking of more scholarships, the platform also focuses on providing a complete guide to Mindanao scholarships. This additional initiative, how is it addressing the unique educational challenges in Mindanao and what lessons can be applied to other regions?
Definitely. So honestly, Edukasyon has been here a while. We've been here since 2015. We're sitting on a lot of data, honestly, of what has been the interests of students from different locations all over the Philippines. And we see some key between different cities. And one of the things we're trying to see now is how do we use that data to share with the different schools located in the different areas of the Philippines, and how can that inform their decisions on how to shape their curriculum and how to improve that so that we're giving quality education inside the classrooms wherever you are in the Philippines, regardless of your access to the information that's in very specific areas.
And lastly, Deirdre, are there plans to expand this model to other parts of the Philippines or even internationally?
So definitely our focus is really the Filipino learner. Mm-hmm. There's still a lot of things that we know we can do for our Filipino students, our Filipino schools, and in general, the nation. So the plans are really, what are the other services and offerings through technology that we can deliver to our Filipino learners? So we're thinking more of like, how can this improve the decision-making of students and parents in terms of like the educational journey? How can we support, for example, employers who are looking for skilled talent how do we bridge their needs with what's being taught in the classroom? So a lot of like collaboration with more people and more organizations in the ecosystem is what they can look forward to with Edukasyon.
And we look forward to talking with you again once everything, of course, is finalized, especially for the new year. Thank you so much, Deirdre Conde, COO of Edukasyon PH.